snowshoes on, everything is packed, so let's start and hike. Well, the snow is much deeper than I thought, and nobody seems to have walked here, so it's quite not that easy to find the path to the bridge where we have to cross. But well, let's just try. Yeah, still hiking. It's quite exhausting today because it's not that cold, and if the sun comes out, it's really very warm and you move on in this deep snow. But when the sun goes away and the wind comes, then it's very cold, so it's not ideal. But I won't complain because the light is wonderful, and yeah, hope to see the musk oxen soon. It's always a gamble if you find them or not. Sometimes in winter time they are high up in the mountains and you have no chance to reach them. You only see them as little black points in the mountains. Still no sight from the musk oxen. Wonderful weather, changing conditions like cloudy and sunny, and a lot of structure in the sky, which is very nice, very welcome. But very exhausting to walk in this really deep snow. Even with the snowshoes, I get sometimes until the knees in the snow, and so that makes it very difficult to walk. But it's fun. And the good thing is it's really not very cold, about -3, as I told you. And oh, what's that? Could be musk oxen. No, I don't think so. It's a stone. It's very often like that. You see a stone in the snow and it looks like a musk oxen. And you get so excited about it. And then you take your binoculars and just a stone. Nothing. Until now, there's absolutely nothing. And you see a lot of stones. Of course, there are much more big stones than musk oxen here. But there's nothing that moves, and even with binoculars I can't see any of them. So this will be quite a hard task today, and I doubt we will find them today. Nonetheless, it's wonderful to be out, to be in this unspoiled nature. The snow is untouched and it's really fantastic to be here. I guess it's not so much, probably they are up high in the mountains, so not reachable for me this time. I'll try tomorrow again, but as I don't see anything, even with binoculars, might be a hard task this year to find them. Have a break, have a tea.
Oh, yeah. Tut das gut.
Yeah. But no musk oxen, huh?
Unfortunately.
Yeah. You can't be lucky every time you go out.
Maybe tomorrow.
Maybe tomorrow is another day.
Yeah.
We will see.
Next chance.
Still hiking. Yeah, it's quite steep. Not too bad, but you have to be careful that you don't sweat too much, because on top it will be windy. And if you get wet under your jacket, then you will freeze. And you will have very cold, and you won't freeze, but you will have very cold. So probably it's better to open the jacket and everything. Yeah, but it's not far. I think I see the end to the top. Guess what? Still hiking. Starts to snow a bit. No sign of the musk oxen. But, well, we just hike and see what we get. Look at that fantastic landscape. It's unbelievable, the light and everything. Would be nice for landscape photography, you know, but I'm eager to climb up that fountain and muscle of oxen. So landscape as a last exit today. Exhausting. Have to drink and eat something very soon. Found them, four of them, and on the other side there are about 20 musk oxen, but they are far away. These four are very relaxed, and yeah, this is a really great day to see them, and the light is getting better, so probably we'll get some really nice shots. They're covered a little bit with snow, which is really welcome for the pictures. Fantastic day. Found the musk oxen. Light was okay, was not great, but it was okay. Fantastic landscape. So now heading back to the camper van where Natasha is waiting for me, and hopefully with a warm tea. And yeah, fantastic. Finally found the musk oxen, and it was really worth the effort hiking all these mountains. A word to distance. It's hard to measure how far away they are because you're not allowed to go closer than 200 meters. I think they might have been probably 150 meters, and that's also because they move. But you should really keep your distance, because in winter if you come too close. And normally they're not aggressive, they just move on. And if you follow them, they move on and they move on. And they don't find a lot of things to eat, so they need their energy. And it's really better not to follow them too close and to leave them the space for your own space safety and for the sake of the animals, which are just great. So, heading back now. Thanks for watching. Hope you liked it, and I hope the photos will be good enough to show you. Bye.